About 8 blocks away from the parade route today, 3 people were stabbed, and one of them, a teenager, was killed. It happened around 1:30 at the intersection of Fayette and Howard Streets. 11 News reporter Kerry Cavanaugh is live at police headquarters with the story. Good evening, Kerry.
Hi there. Well, it's unclear if the people who were stabbed today attended the festivities, but the stabbings did happen within walking distance of the parade route in an area which police tell us was saturated with both undercover and uniformed police detail just for this occasion. City officials estimate that 200,000 people peacefully packed downtown Baltimore to celebrate the Ravens' Super Bowl win. But detectives say a fight broke out about 8 blocks away from the parade route around 1:30 Tuesday afternoon, ending with one man stabbed to death and 2 others wounded.
It is an isolated incident. The victims knew their attackers. We believe this stemmed from a dispute. At this point, there's no information to suggest that these individuals were involved or came here for the Ravens' victory celebration.
Police tell us a group of 15 and 16-year-old boys were involved in the fight. They're confident that crime camera footage will lead to arrests in the triple stabbing.
Over 600 cameras cover the city. They were very successful in capturing some of this incident. Homicide detectives are reviewing that footage, and we have some optimistic leads in reference to this case.
The police department tells 11 News that the city started planning for this parade and the attendant security 2 weeks ago in hopes that the Ravens would win the Super Bowl. We're told state police and 2 other agencies helped the city ramp up patrols and augment its plainclothes detail.
Downtown Baltimore is, you know, one of the safest parts of the city, and we work hard at it. You know, we work hard to invest in camera technology. We work hard in making sure that police officers are there and making sure that people feel safe. What we're going to do now, though, is we're going to find out who did this. We're going to find out who did this on a day that Baltimore was going to celebrate. We owe it to the family and we owe it to the city.
In addition to the young man who was stabbed to death, 2 others are being treated for stab wounds in the hospital. One is listed in serious condition, the other critical. Police say at this point they're not sure how many people were involved in that fight. Reporting live downtown, I'm Kerry Cavanaugh, WBAL-TV 11 News.